Hello friend, welcome to Marine Engineering Hub. This is Ravi Gupta. Today I am going to talk about hypermesh system. Means why the hypermesh system is used and where it is used. After that we will see how the hypermesh system is getting activated and through diagram. And after that we will see how the hypermesh system work through a sketch diagram. And after that we will see the operation. And after that, we will see the actuation of hypermesh through automatic and manual. And after that, we will see stopping. And after that, we will see the advantage of hypermesh system. And how the hypermesh system is always in readiness condition. What are the criteria we need to fulfill? And after that, how we are going to test the alarm? And after that, what are the final flight? How maintenance is be carried out by hypermesh system? So please remain tuned. Till last, you will learn a lot, I guarantee you. Now, before beginning the video, I must want to tell you that I have made one video before about the sprinkler system. Please go and watch that thing. You will learn a lot also that there. And that is also very asked frequently in MEO class 4 and MEO class 2. So, let's begin the thing. What is hypermesh system? So, what is hypermesh? The first question come to our mind is that what is hypermesh? So hypermesh is a very fine form of droplet of water which act like a fog of cloud when high pressure water is injected through nozzle. Means basically the water is been injected in such a way that it form like a fog, like a mist. When injected through a nozzle, it take a space of a fog, like a mist, and that have a effect of cooling, smoothing and extinguishing. We will see there in later slide. Now the second question come to our mind that okay, this hypermesh is a fog like droplets. Where this installation is required? Basically the hypermesh systems is installed where the critical machinery are provided, such as boiler, incinerator, main engine, purifier, oxygenator, steering air room, etc. So as you can see here, this is the hypermesh which is acting like a fog to extinguish the fire, and it is provided in the critical machinery areas. Now the second question come to our mind is that okay, hypermesh is a fog and it is provided in critical machinery area, but how it will activate? So to get the hypermesh activate, it need two detector. Mainly the first is the photoelectric smoke detector and second is the heat detector. So basically it is two detector. How it works? First let me read out, then I will tell you. Hypermesh is activated by two sensor placed near to the each other. So two sensor will place near to the each other. One will be the smoke detector and other will be the flame detector. When both of the detector will get activated, then only the hypermesh system will be activated. If suppose smoke detector is getting activated because of any false smoke or generation or anything, in that case no hypermesh will be activated. Or suppose the flame detector is getting activated but smoke is not getting activated, then no hypermesh will be activated. For activation we need both detector to be activated. Okay, when both get activated, then system inject hypermesh through its nozzle. Okay, hypermesh also provided along with the CO2 system, but both are independent of each other. So what do I mean by that? Suppose a small fire is taking place near an incinerator. In that case, we can't inject CO2 in the engine room. So what we will do? The hypermesh is an automatic system which will detect the fire and which will actuate once both smoke and flame detector will activate it, and it will actuate the hypermesh which will extinguish the fire. So therefore two systems are provided for fixed fire installation for fighting. Both are independent of each other. Now I will show you in this diagram how it is happening. So this is the diagram where above the boiler, as you can see, this is the flame detector, this is the hypermesh, and this is the smoke detector. Now suppose a flame has erupted which is giving a smoke. So smoke detector will get activated, and the flame having a certain frequency range, means whenever a flame occur, it has a certain frequency that will be detected by a flame detector, and once that both will get activated, this hypermist will be injected through this water nozzle and the flame will be extinguished. Now let's see how a hypermist system work. A freshwater pump takes suction from a freshwater tank. A particular dedicated tank is provided in which needs to maintain certain water level with alarm provided as a warning to supply high pressure water to sprinkler head. So basically what happened means in sprinkler system, what will happen? Basically there will be in ship, there are two tanks, starboard or port, or suppose three tank. A particular tank will be dedicated for sprinkler, for hypermist system. And that in that tank, a marking will be made with the alarm level that, okay, this amount of water we need to maintain always. Okay. And if the water level goes below that, alarm will be activated. Okay. That will be done. Same thing I have written here. Each area is isolated by valve, which can be opened during emergency situation involving fire. And one more thing I will show you in my next slide. It will first let me explain this, then we'll understand better. As you can see, this is a dedicated tank. This is a dedicated freshwater tank. Suppose take it as starboard tank. So this is a dedicated starboard tank having an alarm of low level alarm and having a marking indicating that this amount of water, around 20 meter cube or 50 meter cube amount of water, need to be maintained always through that to ensure that sprinkler system is continuously functioning and properly function if any of the section is getting activated or all of them getting activated. So that amount of water need to be maintained. Now this is a tank. Through here the filter, and through this a pump. This pump, and through this pump the water will go and will get, as you can see here, different section: main engine, auxiliary engine, purifier, boiler, incinerator, sharing gear. So from here it will go and water will wait here. This is a solenoid valve, this is a non-intern valve, and this is a hypermist nozzle. Now as you can see here, that water will go and wait here, and this solenoid valve, when actuated, this actuation of solenoid valve is been controlled by main control panel, which will get the signal. Means this solenoid valve will be actuated by the main control panel, which will get signal only when the smoke and the flame detector both are getting activated simultaneously. Okay, now this has activated. Suppose the water is here waiting, and through non-intern valve, which is will always be in open condition, will go and inject the hypermist. Now one more thing I want to show you, that to ensure that the line is clear for a period of time, we have a air bottle connection of a line blowing is provided through a valve to solenoid. We will manually actuate the solenoid. Okay, if for me, suppose we want to check that the main engine line section is clear or not, so what we will do, we will wrap around a plastic or a around the mist section around the nozzle, and we will actuate the solenoid valve manually, and as we'll open the air will go and fill up that plastic and indicating, okay, the line is clear. Same thing you can do of different section for which we want to check that whether that line is clear or not, and also it ensuring that the line have no obstruction. Okay, for that air connection line is provided for line blowing. Now as you can see, this is a section which is provided outside the engine room. Okay, and this is fire control station in which it will provide it, where main control panel is provided, the different section indicating which section is getting activated. And this is a fire detection system where the signal from sensor is coming, like flame detector and smoke detector. The signal will come here and will give to main control panel. Main control panel will process it and will actuate the solenoid valve. Now the main control panel have a three connection: to local control panel, emergency source, and main source. Means the power source is two type: main source and emergency source. As you know, because it is an essential machinery, so it all also be in a readiness condition whether there is a power supply or not. Therefore emergency generator is also providing the power supply, and main supply is also provided by the generator, main generator. and there are two panel. One is the local control panel, this one here, here will be there, and one will be the main control panel, which is outside the engine room. So I hope you understand how it is happening. That's I will tell you in synopsis. Suppose fire has taken place, the signal from flame and smoke data has come to fire detection system, and this will send a signal to main control panel. Main control panel will process it and will send it to junction box, and through junction box, individual unit where the thing has a fire has taken place, suppose at incident of the fire has taken place, it will go and open the solenoid valve. Now the system will also send a signal to the pump starting panel, and the pump will get started, and the water, this valve, these two valve is always in open condition, locked open condition, it is always there, and will take suction, and water and pump will open, and as the solenoid is open already, it will go and it will extinguish the fire through hypermist. Okay, so I hope this diagram is clear. Now how this operation is taking place in a hypermist system? Nozzle having a special design having fine holes. So means in hypermist, the nozzle which is used is the main thing. That is having a fine hole. The water with a high pressure around 4 to 10 megapascal. The pressure of water which is been injected through this nozzle is around 4 to 10 megapascal. Means, okay, as it passes your nozzle get converted into fine particle size of around 50 to 200 micrometer. Okay, so as you can see here that the pressure which through which the water is injected is very high, around 4 to 10 megapascal, and after that the size means the droplet is changing into very minute form, as you can see 50 to 200 micrometer. Okay, so very fine droplet form, and therefore it is forming a fog like structure. Okay, the diffuser action in nozzle drop in pressure, the diffuser action in nozzle drop in pressure at nozzle throat break the liquid particle into fine mist. Okay, the diffuser action means nozzle basically have a action of diffuser action which will break the nozzle in a fine mist. This fine particle are excellent fire extinguisher as it provide large surface area of cooling. So that is the important thing. The fog like mist having a large surface area which is causing a smothering as well as cooling effect. The distance between any two nozzle is very critical, as the area covered by one nozzle must be such that no space is left unspread in that fire affected area. So as you can see here that this nozzle means this nozzle, this water nozzle which is a hypermist nozzle, should be such place that once this mist means water is injected, it should be able to cover that area. If it is not covering that area, then we have to provide more. Means suppose the area which is covered by hypermist is covering 5 meter area. Now the whole boiler platform is up around 10 meter. In that case, we have to provide 2 hypermist so that the whole area can be covered. Okay, so as you can see here, so in diagram, as you can see, the main engine has got 2, auxiliary engine has got 2 hypermist. And depending upon the area, the number of mist is varied so that no area left unturned. Now how the hypermist system will get actuated? So I already have told you it will get automatic actuated, but it can be also manually actuation can be provided, and when we will do, let's see. Water mist system will be automatically released hypermist into the protected area where the fire is detected by fire alarm system. Both need to be activated, smoke and fire meter. An audible visible alarm is activated in that protected area. So as I have told you in this diagram that once the signal is coming from here, the signal will process to junction box and water will go here or here, whatever where the fire has taken place. Means basically the signal is giving when coming to main control panel, it is processing the signal so that area solenoid valve is getting open up, and the water and also the signal is going for the pump starting. So signal from sensor is doing two things. One thing is actuating the solenoid, and second thing starting the pump. Okay, So this is the automatic starting of the pump and automatic actuation of solenoid valve and extinction. So this is called automatic activation. Now, when you will do the manual activation? For manual release, push button is provided in the local control panel at each section on the main control panel at the fire control station. When manual release push button is pressed, the fire alarm as well as the system will be activated in design area. So, as you can see, like this is the solenoid valve. As you can see, this is the solenoid valve going to different section. Okay, and this is like this individual local area. I mean, suppose I will tell you here. Suppose we want to actuate the boiler area mist to check that whether water is coming from here or not. Means sometime what happened that waiting inspector or a PSC inspector come and he will tell, okay, you actuate the incinerator or a boiler hyper mist to show me whether it is working or not. For that, we will have to do manual actuation. For that, what we will do basically, we will, there is a, like this, a push button is provided which will actuate this solenoid valve, and also this start, and we will start the pump manually, and we will open this solenoid valve by pushing that push button. This push button is opening this solenoid valve, and as the pump is started, the water will come through this area and will inject. So we will place a bucket here with a person will be standing with a bucket, and the water will go and will collect it in a bucket. And the surveyor will see, okay, means that is working fine. So basically what I mean to say is that for manual release, the push button is provided which will actuate the solenoid valve and a pump is started manually. Okay, now manual activation is required to test periodically that a particular area hyper mist is working correctly. As I have told you, sometime waiting inspector or PSC personnel want to see actuation of hyper mist at the time we actuate it manually. So what is happening basically, a PSC, a waiting inspector, why he want to see? Because he want to ensure that the firefighting system is always in the readiness condition or not, and working fine or not. And therefore, if you are unable to show him that the hyper mist of that area is not working, in that case he will put a remark, for which the SIP can also be detained. Now we have seen the hyper mist actuation. Now how will it stop? After the extinction of fire, the hyper mist system can be stopped manually. Means manually we will put the pump off, or by cancelling the fire alarm signal from the fire alarm system by pressing the stop button on the control panel or local point. Means once the fire is extinguished, what we will see, and we can stop the button provided on local control panel or main control panel, and the pump will stop and the water injection will stop. Now you have seen means how the hyper mist system is getting actuated and how the hyper mist system is getting stopped. But as you can see here also, means the medium which is used for cooling is what? Water. Now why water is being used? Why not other system is being used? So that question is also asked by surveyor. So water is used because of it has a very good effect. First is the cooling effect, second one is the smoke eliminating effect, third one is the oxygen replacement effect, means smoothing effect, and fourth one is the shut-off effect. So these are all the property for which the water is used as the cooling medium in hyper mist. So let's see. Cooling effect. Mist contain a water molecules which provide the cooling effect when injected at particular area. Means as you know that I want to tell you one thing, that water has a high thermal conductivity and water has a high specific heat. So it can absorb a heat within a small period of time from a particular area, and therefore will have a cooling effect. As you can see, when compression is being made with water, steam and smoke, you can see the specific heat of water is highest, 4.2, whereas the steam is 2.0 and smoke is 1.0 kilojoule. So water has having a high specific heat will provide a more cooling compared to the other mode. Okay, second thing is the smoke eliminating effect. The smoke particles being absorbed and settled by the mist or fog. Okay, the smoke which is generated if any fire take place can be easily be settled by the mist or fog which is provided by the hypermist nozzle, which generated by the hypermist nozzle. Second thing, third thing is the oxygen replacement effect, means smoothing effect. Mist get evaporated by taking the latent heat. The water vapor is heavier than air, replaces the oxygen. So what is happening? As you know, water when changes to steam, it have a high latent heat. Means when a 1 gram of water is converted into 1 gram of steam, it require around 2 to 60 kilojoule per kg of heat to convert 1 kg of water to 1 kg of steam. So as you can see, how much amount of energy is required for conversion. So that energy is being absorbed from surrounding area, providing cooling effect. Second thing is that as it is getting converted into a steam, as steam is heavier than air, it will settle down and it will provide a smoothing effect. So providing two effects, cooling effect as well as smoothing effect. The floating mist as a fog form a layer of water on fire. And fourth thing is a shut-off effect. Means the mist is forming a layer on the floating mist as a fog form a layer of water on a fire. Means it is preventing a fire to spread and covering it and smoothing it. So that I mean to say. So I hope you understand why water is used in a hypermist system as a cooling media. Now, things to take care to ensure that hypermist is always in readiness condition. So what are the things we need to check before to ensure that the hypermist is always in a readiness condition? The first thing is that sufficient water must be maintained in a designated freshwater tank. As I have told you, a freshwater tank designated is provided with a particular alarm, and the valve should be always locked open condition with a tag mark. Okay, so first thing, but what we'll check, always power supply should be available. So for that reason, you have seen in the diagram that two power sources provided, main source, emergency source. As it is critical machinery, power should always be available. Second thing is what I have written, the fire alarm system must be in operation. Means the alarm system should be always in operation, and therefore this is provided by a 24 batteries bolt. Drain and test valve must be closed and well marked. The drain in the line should always be closed condition, and if open, should always be make sure that is closed condition when the system is in operation, and if open, it should be marked. The area around the hypermist water pump must be clear of any obstructions. So as you can see, the nozzle is there. The area around that should be clear of the obstruction, so that once the hypermist is injected, it is spread all over the area. A clear operational procedure for manual and auto operation should be displayed. So as you know that it is a requirement for every fixed fire installation that a layman can also able to operate a fire extinguishing system in case of emergency. For that, the instruction of operation, means which valve to open one by one, should be written there and clearly placed there so that everyone can operate. Now, alarm testing. Low water level alarm test in the freshwater tank. Okay, so as you can see, this is the alarm provided. This alarm is needed to be tested from time to time, indicating that okay, it is functioning properly, correctly. Electrical source failure alarm. We can test by removing the fuse interlock if applicable. Push the start and check the ventilation cutoff. So various alarm is been tested. First is the water level alarm. Second is that okay, we will see means whether the electrical source failure alarm mean to say that suppose the main source is failing, means main source is not there, so emergency source is coming into action or not. So how we will do, we will remove the fuse of main source and we'll check whether the emergency is actuating or not. Okay, interlock if applicable, push the start and check the ventilation cutoff. Oh, now after that we'll see that once the system is been activated, at that time the ventilation is cut off or not. Okay, air blow test. One thing I already told you that here I have shown you in this diagram that the air blowing line is provided. So we will blow it and we'll check it time to time, okay, whether it working fine or not. Okay, now let's see what are the daily round, what are the maintenance we need to check, and what are the check we need to see when we are in a hyperemic system. First one is the daily round check. Any leaking nozzle or leaking valve in the hypermix line to visually check during the round. So means a visual inspection around the hypermix system should be done whenever we are taking a round to see whether okay there is leakage or not. No leakage is there, should be there. Control panel should be checked for any abnormal indication. We should see that the control panel should not have any red light indicating okay that area is having false alarm or everything is working fine or not. We will see that in normal daily routine check. Monthly routine check. Pump operation to be checked, running condition, water pressure, and any abnormal noise or vibration. Okay, so what we know, as we know that the pump is means in monthly we are checking the pump condition for any water, any vibration, any noise, and we are also checking the pressure of 4 megapascal, 10 megapascal, is that pressure is in build up by the pump or not. Okay, we will check that when the pump is in operation. We also check visually wire connection to be checked and lamp test to be checked. Okay, lamp test button is provided. We'll press that button and we'll check that all lamp is working fine or not. If any lamp is not lighting up, in that case we'll change the bulb. Okay, now 6 month routine. Various alarm to be checked as mentioned in previous, means various alarm as you have known here, low water level alarm, means emergency source failure alarm, air blow test, means ventilation cutoff alarm, all this alarm 6 monthly we'll check. And check the interlock, means what interlock it means to say that we will give a flame sensor, we'll actuate the flame sensor, we'll see whether the hypermix is actuating or not. When, and after that we will actuate the smoke sensor and we'll see that hypermix system is actuating or not. Means what we'll see that once if we are providing one system at a time, it should not actuate. If we are providing two things, both smoke and flame, then it should actuate. That thing we will check. Okay. Yearly routine check. Check the clogging of nozzle. We can do it by air blowing, as I have told you. Overall, the pump unit, suction valve filter. Basically, in yearly routine, we will clear the here in individual. After individual solenoid valve, there is a section. In section line, there is a filter provided. That need to be clear, means that we can the dirt and a dirt accumulation we need to get clear. And also, as I have told you in this diagram, that here the filter, this filter need to be cleaned. So all this we will check. So I hope, friend, you have learned about the hypermix system, different thing, and I hope this video will be beneficial for you, clearing all the doubt regarding hypermix. And I hope you have learned today. Please do like and subscribe, and please share and please subscribe, because I am making this video with lot of hard work. So please to keep me encouraged to make this such kind of video, please subscribe. Thank you, friend. Have a good day.